Today, I'm going to show you how to make your own YouTube channel's live subscriber counter widget with iOS 14. Let's get into it. What's up, guys? I'm Shaq, and this channel is all about tech. Apple has recently launched the new iOS 14, where you can basically customize everything on your phone. You can like add widgets, you can like edit the icons. It's awesome. Let me just bring my phone real quick. Okay, so this is basically my screen, so you guys can like follow whatever I'm doing on my phone. I found this thing really interesting because as a content creator, I always feel the need of tracking my subs count. This is actually how I customized my home screen. If you guys want to have the same template that I'm running on my phone, all you need to do is like clicking the link in the description box below. The link number 4 has all the icons, the wallpaper as well, and everything you need to set your phone like this. If you want to learn how to actually change the icon, like replace the icon with the customized icon, all you need to do is watch my previous video. I've left the link in the description box below as well. Okay, the first thing you need to do is go into the App Store and download an app called Widget. Okay, I don't know how to pronounce this thing. English is not my mother language, but okay, Widget. You're gonna open this app, and this is the screen that you're going to get. The next thing you need to do is click on plus right here, and you're gonna click on start empty, okay? You're gonna click on the plus right here again, and then you're going to search for something called text from JSON URL. You're going to click on text from JSON URL. You're going to click on empty, and then you're going to click on the green side of JSON text will be here, and this is where the magic actually happens. So what we'll be doing here is basically fetch our YouTube channel's details such as the ID and the API key and bring it to this section right here. Normally to do this, you would require some coding skills, but don't worry, I've got you guys. I've prepared everything for you guys. All you need to do is just copy the codes that I'm gonna leave in the description box below and then paste it right here. The next thing you're gonna do is open your browser on your computer. Okay, so I'll be doing this on my computer because I had some errors on my phone, so I would recommend you guys to do it on your computer as well. Okay, so the next thing you need to do is go straight to console.developers.google.com. Do not worry, I've left the link in the description box below. This is the link number 1, okay? It's the link number 1. You're gonna type your email right here, you're gonna log in. Once you're logged in, you're gonna see something similar to this page. The next thing you need to do is click on library. You need to scroll down and search for something called YouTube Data API version 3. You're gonna click on this, and then you're gonna click on enable, okay? This is gonna take some time, like 10 to 15 seconds. And then you're gonna click on credentials, and you're gonna see a page that looks like this, okay? I already have one credential created right here. All you need to do is just click on create credentials, select API key, okay? It's gonna create the API key, and then it's gonna give it to you. All you need to do is click on copy right here and click on close. Okay, now you need to paste it somewhere. I'm gonna paste it on my email because at the end of the day, I'm gonna send these commands via email to my phone. Now we need to retrieve our YouTube's channel ID. To do this, you need to click over here and then go to settings. Under settings, you're gonna see advanced settings option on the left tab. You're gonna copy the channel ID that is right here. I'm gonna paste it on my email again. Now I've got my API key and I've got my channel ID as well. All you need to do now is copy the URL, which is in my description box under number 2, okay? Under number 2. You're gonna paste it over here. And as you guys can see, I've got two options which are written blank and blank, okay? So the last blank is the key. I'm gonna copy my API key. I'm gonna copy, I'm gonna paste it right here after the equal sign, okay? I'm gonna paste it over here. And then I'm gonna copy my channel's ID right here and replace it on the blank which comes after the ID, okay? I'm gonna replace it, and now we're good to go. So this is basically a code that we're going to need. Now I can just delete these previous codes that I had before. And the last thing you need to do is copy the key path, which is under number 3 in the description box below. I'm gonna paste it right here. and then I'm gonna send it to myself so that I can receive this email on my phone so that I can copy the URL properly. As you guys can see, I've already received the email that I've sent from my computer to my phone. All I need to do is like copy the first link, okay? I'm gonna select it, I'm gonna click on copy. Okay, I'm actually keeping it blurred because it's my sensitive information, so I don't want you guys to see it. I'm gonna go to the Widget app. I don't know how to pronounce this thing. You guys need to teach me. I'm gonna paste it under URL, okay? And then I'm gonna go back to the email, and then I'm gonna copy the second command, okay? I'm gonna copy the second command. I'm gonna go back to the Widget app, and then I'm gonna paste it under keypad. Once this is done, I'm gonna click on back. And as you guys can see, I've got an error which says error loading JSON. So you need to click on the green side once again, and right at the beginning of the keypad, as you guys can see, there is a small space over here, okay? So you guys need to like delete this thing right here so that the command starts exactly with the letter O. And then I'm gonna click on back, and as you guys can see, I already have my subscribers right here. I only have 650 subscribers. If you guys wanna help me out reach 1,000, please subscribe to the channel. I would be grateful. Now, we're almost done. All we need to do is like finish the customization of the widget. So I'm gonna click on 650 right here. I'm gonna increase the size of the font. I'm gonna add italic because I love italic. I'm gonna click on the background color. I'm gonna select the red color, like the first, second, third, and the fourth tone of red color, because this actually matches with the icons that I have. I'm gonna come back, and then I'm gonna activate this option right here, which says gradient. And then I'm gonna go back once again. As you guys see, I've got the red background and the subscribers right there. I'm gonna click on the plus sign once again, and then I'm gonna come to image right here, and then I'm gonna click on the middle image. I'm gonna click on photo library, and then I'm gonna upload the YouTube logo right here, okay? I'm gonna click on fill because I want the logo to be like filled completely on the entire widget. And then I'm gonna click on back. I'm gonna click on done, okay? Once this is done, this is the widget that I've got right here. I'm gonna minimize this and I'm going to my main screen. Now to add the widget, all you need to do is like press on an app, and then you're gonna go into the jiggle mode. Next up, you'll click in the plus sign right here. You're gonna scroll down and search for Widget. Widget is right here. You're gonna click on Widget, and then you're gonna select the medium size widget. You're gonna add the widget, and then you're gonna tap once on it. You're gonna choose the widget that you've selected before, which is the new widget. Once you're done with this, you're gonna click like outside of the square, and here we go. We've got the YouTube live subs counter. Guys, thanks a lot for watching. If you guys like my video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment below, as it helps me in growing this channel and reaching more people interested in this content. See you next time. Peace.